Ladies and gentlemen, the greatest music of all time.
WTOB, Winston-Salem.
I started in the business when I was 15. Got interested a number of years earlier, listening to, as a matter of fact, WTOB. I had a lot of friends in the neighborhood we grew up with, a little older. They were listening to this really cool sound coming out of this little transistor radio music. It was the Beatles. It was probably some Rolling Stones in there, Dave Clark Five, different groups. And I'm going like to my neighbor across the street. I said, "What is that?" And he says, "That's WTOB." And I was going, "Wow, that's really cool." 1968. There was really not any big seed planted then. It happened over the next several years. When I got into high school, I thought, "Well, this is cool. Really good business. Really good." This will be fun. This would be a fun thing to do, be a disc jockey on the radio. So back then, you had to have a license from the Federal Communications Commission because of the transmitters. You had to make sure that they didn't drift off of frequency or that they didn't increase or decrease in power that was allowed for that particular frequency. So you had to know how to do mathematical equations that got you to confirm that you were in the right. So I got the license when I was 15 years old and went on the air. Fast forward to now, after a whole career in broadcasting, and here I am working at WTOB, which is where it all began. After World War II, people who were, and there were radio stations that, of course, were on the air prior to that, but the proliferation of commercial radio like we know it today came in like gangbusters. Near the end of the war, this station was signed on in 1947. WTOB call letters were first used I think April 22nd was when the station went on the air. WTOB is a tip of the hat to R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, because one of the founders of the station was executive assistant to R.J. Reynolds, and so WTOB is Winston Tobacco. And over the ensuing 30 plus years under the ownership of Southern Broadcasting Corporate Company, under their ownership, they grew their station count to at least seven that I can remember. Music changed in the mid-50s when rock and roll came around. Elvis Presley, you know, the mixing of blues and country music to create rock and roll happened in that time period from the mid to late 40s all the way through into where we are today. You know, people like Buddy Holly and the Everly Brothers, influences that they carried. Even here in Winston-Salem, the Five Royales, a group that was inducted in 2015 into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as an early influencer of rock and roll, the guys started right here in Winston-Salem. And the sound that you hear influenced the musicians that, some of whom now we hear today, they're getting their influence from those artists that were back in the mid to late 50s. So music and radio and how the whole magic of radio comes about, the entertainment, the things that happen in a community that can be reflected and celebrated in radio is is magic. The owner of the radio station in Myrtle Beach that I worked for and the general manager encouraged us at a very young age to get involved in the JCs, which then led into the Chamber of Commerce, which gave us, you know, opportunity to meet business people and find out what the needs of the community were and go and address those needs, which the Federal Communications Commission says is something that we're supposed to be doing with that license. Bigger companies that own the 100,000 watt, the 50,000 watt stations that cover a particular market like Greensboro, High Point, Winston-Salem, there's no way that they can serve Winston-Salem while they're trying to serve the whole market. And so some of those stations have become more like an over-the-air Pandora. But we have disc jockeys that are on the air, that are live. And that's the part of broadcasting that is sometimes lost in what is happening in a community. Now, what we're seeing, and I have several friends of mine who own their own radio stations in different markets, they're doing the exact same thing we are. We're not unique in any particular way, but we've been able to, with the FCC's several things that are happening with regard to FM signals, to allow us to do what we're doing and make money at it and really serve Winston-Salem.